In my eyes, scientists are not more crazy than regular people, but just more curious. However, when I imagine how people watch the series Big Bang Theory, then I can identify some characters that you could also find in regular physics groups. My name is Philip Walther. I'm a quantum physics professor at the University of Vienna at the Faculty of Physics. The University of Vienna is an amazing place, and the reason is that here with the colleagues we like to investigate the foundations, the basic principles of quantum physics, which later on can open up entirely new directions. And this distinguishes us from other research groups who rather follow given paths and basically try to optimize and develop applications, technologies for also important things, but we really focus here on the basics. My research contributes to at least two social benefits. On one hand, obtaining insights into new phenomena, but on the other hand, also to be able to contribute to this worldwide effort in developing quantum technology that goes beyond the capabilities of classical devices. So for instance, our group contributes to building quantum computers as well as to develop new schemes for secure communication and other applications. Our developments of quantum technology is and will be relevant in the near future by opening up new possibilities for quantum computers and quantum communication, which hold the promise to revolutionize our near-term future. Although we can find quantum physics in everyone's life by looking at lasers, which is explained by quantum physics, or chemistry, or pharmacy, where we tailor molecules to fulfill properties, we face now another revolution, so-called second revolution, where we really work with individual quantum particles which allow to go beyond the technologies, because the capability of playing with those gives access to devices which cannot be achieved with classical technology, such as quantum computers, secure quantum communication, and precision measurements. And this revolution happens now, and our group is part of that, where we believe that in a few years from now, those devices will become part of everyone's life. My advice for young researchers is just follow your motivation. And that's out of experience, because when I look at myself, my way to getting there was very untypical. The reason is that my chemistry teacher excited me much more than my physics teacher, and therefore I studied chemistry at the university. During the end of my studies, I read physics books from my father, and I got super excited about quantum physics, the phenomena you see there, there's the magic that one particle can be observed at two positions, that you have this magic entangled states where the observation of one particle affects the other one, and I wanted to understand it much better, and I wanted to do experiments to really see those effects in my hand. And that was the possibility at the University of Vienna when I joined the group of Anton Zeilinger.